Hey, so this video is going to focus on a few different examples on order of operations. So when we're given examples on order of operations, they can look all sorts of different ways. We can have these long, stretched out problems. We can have some fraction problems, absolute value, exponents, just all sorts of different things. So when it does come to order of operations, we do hopefully need to at least keep in mind our rules. So that's our Pemdas, right? Or one of the way that you may know that is, please excuse my dear Aunt Sally. That's a very common acronym to help students remember the order of this. So as long as we're following that order, we should be good as far as simplifying our order of operations, as long as we remember our rules when it comes to calculating some of these things. I highly recommend, if you are not experienced yet in adding, subtracting, multiplying, dividing integers, so positive, negative numbers, you should definitely go back and practice those kind of calculations, because you're going to see them pop up all over the time in order of operations. Otherwise, taking a look at the specific problem that we have here, keeping in mind PEMDAS tells us to start with parentheses first. Now, typically that P stands for parentheses, in which we have a few things going on inside of our parentheses. What I mean by that, it does not just imply this negative 2 maybe that's inside that parentheses. Those kind of parentheses are kind of just meant to separate a number from a different number. So this parentheses, as far as PEMDAS is concerned, is where we actually have calculations going on inside parentheses. So for our particular problem, that would maybe mean these brackets here. Square brackets, curly brackets are essentially the same thing as parentheses. So we have two sets of square brackets within this problem. So both of those would apply to the P in PEMDAS. So that tells us that we need to focus on simplifying what's going on inside these square brackets first. Now, when we're looking at these square brackets, we need to make sure that we follow order of operations inside of these square brackets. So I'm going to take a look at our first set of square brackets over here on the left-hand side. And inside there, I have a few things going on. So I have a negative 2 plus a 7 minus a negative 5. Now, luckily for us, though, that's all addition and subtraction. And addition and subtraction can be done in order from left to right. If we're following order of operations within these square brackets, again, we're starting with P. We don't have any exponents in there. We don't have any multiplication. We don't have division. So we can go straight to adding and subtracting. And adding and subtracting, you can just go in order from left to right, which means that we can go ahead and start with a negative 2 plus a 7. So negative 2 plus a 7, so those we are adding with different signs. So that tells us to subtract the numbers. 7 minus 2 is a 5, and we keep the sign of the bigger number, so that's going to be a positive 5. Now we're going to drop down this minus and negative 5 that we have there, and we're still working within these square brackets. Now, one important thing to remember when it comes to this problem right here, or this calculation, is the double negative rule. So we have a rule called the double negative rule that says anytime you have two negatives side by side, they are going to cancel out to a positive. So because we have these two minus signs side by side here, we can cancel those out. That's going to change this to a 5 plus a 5, which is a 10. So we're going to pause for just a bit, and now we're going to work on this right side over here, that set of square brackets that we have. So also do notice we also have the double negative rule inside there, because we have negative 4 minus a negative 10. And because of these two negative signs that we have inside of there, those are going to cancel out to plus signs. So really we have negative 4 plus 10. So we're also going to be adding with different signs there, which tells us to subtract our numbers. 10 minus a 4 is a 6, and that's going to be a positive 6. So then we need to drop down that plus sign that we had hanging out in between those square brackets. And our last and final step here is going to excuse me, is going to be to do 10 plus 6, which is 16. So 16 is our final answer here. All right, so our next order of operations example is going to be one in fractional form like we have here. So the one main important thing that we need to remember about these kind of examples is that we're going to treat the numerator and the denominator almost as if they were their own problems. So we're going to work on simplifying everything in the numerator, then we'll work on simplifying everything in the denominator, and our last step is going to be to divide that numerator divided by the denominator. So let's start working on the numerator. So we need to keep our order of operation rules in mind as we're working through this problem. So PEMDAS, so let's see. Starting with parentheses, I do not have any parentheses in my numerator. The next thing that we have is an exponent, and we do have two of those. So we have 12 squared and we have 2 squared. Starting with 12 squared, remember that 12 squared means 12 times 12, which is 144. Then we have plus 2 squared. So I'm going to go ahead and write in that plus sign. And 2 squared, so 2 times 2 is a 4. And I'm just going to carry over that minus an 8. Still working on the numerator. So let's see. We didn't have parentheses. We took care of exponents. We do not have any multiplication or division going on. But we do have addition and subtraction. And we can do that in order from left to right. 144 plus a 4 gives us 148, but then 148 minus that 8 gives us 140. So our simplified numerator is 140. Moving down to our denominator, so we need to use our order of operations once again, all within our denominator. Starting with parentheses, which we don't have here. Keep in mind that the parentheses that we have down here, that's actually multiplication. It's not parentheses as far as order of operations is concerned. It would be parentheses only if we had a calculation going on inside those parentheses. But because it's just a single number, a single digit, that just means multiplication. So we skip over the P. And we can move on to exponents. So we do have one exponent. We have 10 squared, and 10 times 10 is 100. So I'm just gonna bring over the rest of the problem. So we have 100 minus negative 4 times negative 15. So we took care of our exponent, which means we look at multiplication division next. We do have multiplication. We need to multiply that negative 4 times a negative 15. So I'm going to carry over the 100 and the minus sign. And taking care of negative 4 times negative 15, that gives us a positive 60. So we still have one more calculation to take care of in our denominator. So I'm going to bring this over down over here. Our numerator was 140. In our denominator, we have 100, and we're subtracting 60 from it, so we get 40 there. So leaving us with 140 over 40. And let's see, we can try and divide this here. So we're left with this fraction, 140 over 40. Keep in mind that a fraction is the same thing as division as well. But we can't really divide 140 by 40. And a lot of times, most of the books, most of our teachers do not want us to leave it as a decimal. So plugging this into the calculator is not going to help us here. So this just means that we need to work on simplifying this fraction. So taking a look at 140 and 40 and coming up with the biggest number that they both have in common. So let's see. 140 and 40, I believe that 20 is the greatest common factor here. So I'm going to divide out a 20 from our numerator and our denominator. And if I do so, that gives me 7 over 2. So because a 7 and a 2 has nothing in common, I know that is my simplified answer. So 7 halves is our final answer here. And the last example that I'm going to focus on for order of operations for this particular video is going to be this one right here. It It has a little bit of absolute value thrown in there. So again, we need to keep in mind our rules for order of operations. So starting with parentheses. Now that P stands for parentheses, and that means regular looking parentheses. That means square brackets. That means curly brackets. And it also means absolute value bars. When it comes to our order of operations sequence here, absolute value bars mean the same thing as a parenthesis, or that's the way that we treat it anyways. So because we have two sets of absolute value bars for this problem here, we do need to focus on simplifying those first. Starting with the absolute value bars to the left, that is a 5 minus a 9. So we're going to go ahead and do that subtraction first. 5 minus 9 is going to give us a negative 4. Again, keep in mind, if you have $5 in your bank account and you spend $9, you are now negative. So that's going to be a negative 4. I'm going to drop down the minus sign and work on simplifying the next set of absolute value bars, which is a negative 3 plus a 6. So that is adding with different signs. So that tells us to subtract the numbers. 6 minus 3 is a 3, and it is a positive 3. Now that we're done simplifying within the absolute value bars, we actually need to take the absolute value. Now remember that absolute value, the definition says that absolute value is the distance away a number is from zero on the number line. Or a much easier way to think about it is that absolute value bars make things positive. So if you have something negative inside the absolute value bars, like this negative 4 that we have, it's going to turn it positive. Or if we have something that's already positive, well, it's just going to stay positive. So we're taking the absolute value of these numbers. So absolute value of a negative 4 is 4. Absolute value of a 3 is 3. And we're going to drop down that minus sign in between there so that we can do our final calculation of a 4 minus a 3, which is a 1. So that 1 there is our final answer for this particular problem.